This is Coyote News.
Every year for D-Days, Vermilion bars and restaurants ramp up their security. A major facet of homecoming is the reminder to check IDs and to look out for fakes. In this week's Yolt Report, Coyote News' Jonathan Hee takes a look at one local restaurant's procedures.
Bars in Vermilion have been running into the issue of minors attempting to get into bars with fake IDs. Depending on what type of fake ID they have, will determine if they get admitted to the bar. Joshua Shear is the general manager of the Brickhouse Bar, and he explains how their door person identifies fake IDs.
When you get the ID, when you first get it in your hands, you can kind of tell by their mannerisms if they're nervous or that sort of thing. It's not 100% telltale sign. The biggest thing that they have to do is run the finger across the ID, kind of feel the texture of it. You know, the newer IDs, you can definitely tell when there's a fake or if they're not.
Shear also says that having a fake ID doesn't only affect the person, it affects the employees as well.
When people come in here with a fake, they're not just risking the business. You know, it's the server. The business itself can't be held 100% responsible, other than the fact that our training regiment wasn't good enough, and that's why I didn't catch it. Then it's on us, but either way, you're still risking the job of the person that you're handing that fake ID to.
Shear also emphasizes that his staff always IDs no matter what age they look. For Coyote News, I'm John Hee.